Greetings friends, today we are here to learn how we can deploy our Golang application onto a server for free. In this tutorial, I'll be using a GitHub repository to deploy my code. So the first thing that I would want to do is go to the following link and then fork the project for use. Once I do that, the next step will be to open up my favorite browser and then enter the following link zit.co/r/cypher. So the first thing that you might want to do when you reach the Zit homepage will be to press login at the top right corner and enter the credentials for your GitHub account. This will allow Zit to access your repositories, identify who you are, and make the process of deployment much easier. With just two clicks, we were able to log into our GitHub account. Now, if you come to the pricing tabs on the Zit website, you will see that Zit offers us one free project with all its amazing services. But you can also have this professional account for just $5 a month, which, if you ask me, is an absolute steal. With that, let's move on. Once the login is done, I can simply click on New Project and then select GitHub. Here, as we can see, I have a number of repositories, but what I want to do is use Golang Demo. I'll continue with it and then let's give it a different name. I think Golang Demo will do. I'll press on Deploy. Here it will give us two options. The first will be to deploy using a Docker file, but since we want to use Golang itself to make the process as similar to the local server as possible, I'll simply use the following settings and then press save. Once I do that, the build will start automatically. All I need to do after this is to wait for about a minute and let the build get complete. So let's skip ahead. But the project was successfully deployed. So the next thing that I would do is go to the dashboard and click on visit. As we can see, we get a success message onto the browser. Thus, we can verify that our project was successfully deployed. Here, I would like to show you a special feature of Zit. Here, I'll go to the repository that I deployed and then open main.go. Here, let's make a few changes and press commit. Once this is done, let's go back to the dashboard, and on the deployment tab, I can see that the project has started to build itself again. Zit allowing us to constantly make changes without worrying about its deployment. You can also see that the original or the previous build is still intact and won't be removed until the building of the new project is done. Let's skip ahead. So let's go back to the URL and press refresh. As we can see, our changes have been added successfully. I hope this was a productive session for you. With that, I'll end today's lecture. Thank you.